Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to create a country-by-country report in Tax Reporting Cloud. Country-by-country reporting, or CBCR, is a new disclosure requirement for large multinational enterprises. It's a three-tier requirement calling for a CBCR template, master file, and local file. The CBC report includes country-level financial data, such as related party revenue, third-party revenue, tax paid, and so on. Tax authorities use this information to assess transfer pricing risk and make determinations on how they allocate tax audit resources. Once you've completed the setup for CBCR, you can begin the reporting process by entering your data, consolidating and translating it, and then generating and publishing the report in XML. Let's review this process. The first step is to load or enter your data. I'll open the data entry card and view Table 1. If you are using Tax Reporting Cloud for tax provisioning and have assigned the CBCR attributes to the source accounts, you populate the map data row by first consolidating the console cube so that entities have an OK status. Then you run the Consolidate CBCR business rule to populate Table 1. Note that consolidating the provision does not automatically impact the CBCR consolidation status. You will need to set the status of the entities to impacted in CBCR by entering data such as constituent entity data or entity-specific exchange rates. Confirm that CBCR consolidation status is impacted before running the CBCR consolidation. If you use Tax Reporting Cloud just for CBCR, you can set up and use any of the following EPM modules to load or enter data: Data Management, Supplemental Data Management, SDM, Smart View. You can also manually enter your data. If you use Data Management, your data shows in the Manage Data row. If you use SDM, your data shows in the Supplemental Data row. If you use Smart View or natively import a file, it's best practice to use the Automated Data Input row. The Adjustment Data Input row is for manual entry. The second step is to enter data for Tables 2 and 3 and constituent entity information. Use Table 2 to enter the nature of the main business activity or activities carried out by the entity in the relevant tax jurisdiction. You'll answer yes or no to each of these activities. Use Table 3 to provide any additional information or analysis to facilitate the understanding of the CBC report. Use the Constituent Entity Information form to list all of the constituent entities of the multinational enterprise group which are resident for tax purposes in the relevant tax jurisdiction. You can extend this form if you have more than 10 entries to list. The third step is to consolidate your data. You can use the Data Status CBCR form to view data status and run the consolidation. This data status form is specific to the CBCR cube. To consolidate, click Actions, then Business Rules. Select Consolidate CBCR and select the desired entity, scenario, period, and year. Once the consolidation program has run successfully, entities have an OK status. The fourth step is to translate your data to your reporting currency or currencies. I'll click Actions, then Business Rules. And translate CBCR. For reporting currency, I'll select USD. For entity, I'll select I descendants of total geography. Click Launch to run. The last step is to generate the report and publish in the XML format. I'll click on Publish XML to open the report. I'll click Report Actions, Download as XML, then CBC Report XML. This creates a zip file with two files. The first file is a validation report. When this report is empty, there are no validation errors. The other file is the XML report for filing. This is the file you upload to the tax authority. In this tutorial, you learned how to create a country-by-country report in Oracle Tax Reporting Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.